Hi everyone, I'm Miss Katie from Rockland Public Library, and today we're going to be reading I Am the Shark. I Am the Shark is by Joan Holub and illustrated by Laurie Keller. This is a cool book because it is a fiction story, so it's a made-up story about a shark, but it also is filled with real shark facts. So it has some fiction to it and some nonfiction because it has real things about facts inside. So let's see what happens in I Am the Shark. Hey there, my name is Great White Shark, and I'm the greatest shark in this book.
No, you're not.
Who said that?
I'm a whale shark. I'm the greatest shark in this book because I'm the biggest. I'm as big as a school bus. I'm the biggest fish on Earth. I'm so big, I don't even fit on this page. Compared to me, you are small.
Interesting theory, but being small is great too. It means you can swim through spaces where you won't fit. Plus, I don't have to eat as much as you. It saves time on hunting. Hooray! I'm the smallest shark in this book.
No, you're not.
Now who said that?
I'm the smallest.
You see, it's so tiny.
I'm the smallest. I'm only as big as a person's hand. Dwarf Lantern Shark is my name. Small and glowing, that's me. I can fit through even smaller spaces than you.
All right. I'm thinking that a tiny shark like you probably has a tiny brain. I'm smart and curious. Maybe I'm the smartest shark in this book.
Or maybe not. I'm a hammerhead shark. I've got a large brain between these eyes. One, two. The eyes are on both sides of my hammer-shaped head. And while I'm thinking smart thoughts, I can also see up and down and all around. I've got better view of the ocean than any other shark.
Whoa, how can I top that? Top. Hey, that's it. I have a gray top or back. Unsuspecting prey from above don't even notice me against the dark colored water below, and then chomp. Yet my tummy is white. So to the prey looking up from below me, I blend into the light, the sky above. That is called countershading. Countershading. Does that make sense? So the shark's talking about how one side of it, the top side of it, is dark and the bottom side of it is light. So when it's swimming, people looking down or animals looking down, fish looking down, are looking at the bottom of the ocean floor, which is dark. So the dark part of the shark here blends in and it won't see it against that dark floor. But if someone's swimming below, they're looking up at the bright sky and the shark's belly is white, so it blends in with the bright sky. So it's camouflage, whether you look down or up, and it's two different colors, countershading. Does that make me the sneakiest shark in this book? What do you think? Might this shark be the sneakiest shark?
No, you're not.
Oh, who said that?
I don't know.
Huh?
I'm not sure.
Do you see who's hiding?
I don't know how you could. They're hiding very well.
You see this right here? That is a shark.
Surprise! I'm an angel shark.
Camouflage makes me the sneakiest shark in this book. My back is covered with spots, so when I hide under the sand just now, I looked like part of the ocean floor. Then, woohoo, ambush. Aw, crumbs. Guess I'm not the sneakiest after all. Wait, I know. I'm great at finding prey, like seals and sea lions and small whales. I must be the best hunter in this book. What do you think? Are they the best hunter?
No.
I'm a good hunter as you, maybe better. I'm a tiger shark. I hunt animals like seals and squid, but there's a reason they call me the garbage can of the ocean. It's because I gobble other stuff too. One time I ate a clock and a tire. True story.
Well, it's better for the environment if garbage doesn't even wind up in the oceans, though.
Sigh. This being one-upped is getting old. 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 That reminds me, I've been in this book since the very first page. So I must be the oldest shark in this book.
No, you're not. Ooh, who's this? No, you're not. I'm Greenland Shark. I am 400 years old. Holy smokes. No other animal with vertebrae, that's a back or a spine. So no other animal with a back or a spine. No other animal with a vertebrae can live longer than that. So you are definitely younger than me.
Okay, moving on. Let's see. I've got fins like a fish. Maybe I'm the fishiest shark in this book. All sharks are fish. Well, and we all have fins. Okay, good point. Still, I'm the great white shark, so I've got to be the greatest at something, right? Let's review some shark facts. Maybe it'll help me find out what I'm greatest at. Here goes. All right, let's first look at a little diagram of me. Oh, the great white shark. Because not all sharks have the same body parts. Here, I have dorsal fins for balance and turning. I have a caudal fin. This tail fin pushes me forward, which is super important. The anal fin gives extra stability. Two pelvic fins for stability so I don't roll over and to help me stop. Two pectoral fins to stay afloat and steer. I have a lateral line, tubes under my skin, along both sides of my body that detect the movement of prey in the water. That's pretty cool. The spiracle, which breathes a breathing opening, gills pull oxygen from water for breathing, pit organs located on my back, side, and jaw. These detect water currents that might lead me to prey. I have nostrils for smelling, I have a snout, and I have an ampullae of Lorenzi, a system of jelly-filled pores on my head that detect electrical fields caused by movement of prey in the water. Oh, so cool. They have so many things that help them find things to eat. So many little, like we have the lateral line and the pit organs, and the ampullae of Lorenzi that all help them hunt even better. Now for some fantastic shark facts. Sharks are fish. Most fish have bones, but sharks don't. Our skeletons are made of cartilage, just like people's ears. You want to touch your ear? Touch your ear and wiggle it around. Your ear doesn't have bones in it. It has cartilage. Lobsters. So sharks, they bend and we can twist and turn and swim fast. It's lightweight, so it helps us float too. Sharks have fins that act like paddles. Tilting a fin helps us change directions, move up and down, or forward, or move slower or faster. Sharks and people have five senses. Do you know what some of the senses are? Can anyone at home list the senses? What do you think? We have our five senses: hearing, smell, touch, sight, and taste. Sharks also have these: the ampullae of Lorenzi, the lateral line, and the pit organs. Those are things we all looked at the past page, right? Right here, the pit organs and the lateral line, which all help detect electronic fields and magnetic fields, temperature changes, and even ocean currents. Some sharks, like the great white, like me, must keep swimming to breathe underwater. Water flows into our open mouths as we swim, and our bodies pull oxygen from the water as it flows back out of us through the slits in the side called gills. So they pull in their water and then they push it out of the side of their face. Female sharks are usually bigger than male sharks. We have lots of teeth in rows. If a tooth falls out, no problem. Another one moves forward to take its place. Can you imagine if that happened? When your baby teeth fell out, there was just another tooth right inside your mouth. You had a couple layers of teeth and the other one just moved forward. Wow. Some babies hatch from eggs. Many other shark babies, moms give birth to them. Live young sharks are called pups. Newborn shark pups can swim right away. Can you imagine being born and immediately being able to walk or run? That's what sharks can do. When they're born, they come out and they can swim. Sharks are covered with tiny scales called denticles that protect us like a knight in shining armor. Our skin feels smooth if you stroke us from head to tail, but it feels like sandpaper if you stroke us in the opposite direction. Sharks have lived on the earth since before the dinosaurs. Most sharks are meat eaters called carnivores. We are amazing hunters. Predators, top of the food chain. We hunt and eat other animals called prey, such as fish or seals. Some sharks eat plants and tiny animals called plankton. Speaking of food, I got a feeling. It's snack time. Snack alert. Let's go. I'll race ya. Whoever gets there first wins the prey. All right, here we are on the starting line. Go! Whoosh! Hooray! Woohoo! I'm faster than the other sharks. I'm way ahead. I'm going 35 miles an hour. I'm the fastest swimmer in this book. A third of a mile away or more. I smell you, snacks. 800 feet away. I hear you. 30 to 50 feet away. Snack attack, I see you. Any minute now, here I come. Whoosh. Huh? Who is that? I'm Mako, the fastest shark in this book. I've been clocked swimming 46 miles an hour. I win the prey. Hooray. Oh, the shark's not the fastest shark either, huh? All the other sharks in this book are better than me. Could it be that I'm not really the greatest? Maybe I should change my name to Just Okay White Shark or Not So Great White Shark. Dude, there's always going to be someone that's bigger, smaller, glowier, smarter, sneakier, older, faster, or whatever. Just be happy being you. Happy? That's it. Everyone loves my big, bright smile. They take my picture wherever I go. I mean, who else do you know with 300 jagged triangle-shaped 2-inch long pearly whites?
It's awesome to be me!
Beware of sharks. I have the greatest smile in this book. The end.
And I highly suggest checking this book out. It is a lot of fun. It has lots more ocean facts, but these are some of the animals that we talked about, or the sharks that we talked about today. We had our lead here, the great white shark. We had the mako shark, the fastest. The angel shark, the sneakiest. The hammerhead shark, the brainiest. The whale shark, the biggest. The dwarf lantern shark, the smallest. The Greenland shark, the oldest. And the tiger shark, AKA the garbage can. Wait a second. And the bear shark? The furriest? You're not a shark. What is this? Excuse me, but sharks do not have fur or claws. So you are not a shark. You seem cool and all, but you are a bear. Obviously, a bear does not belong in a shark book.
Great point. I know. I'll go find my own book to star in. I will call it I Am the Bear. I'll be the only bear inside it. It'll be all about me, 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 only me. Awesome possum. Later, shark. The end.
Great listening, everyone. This even has some great other books to check out in the back of it and some great resources. So I highly recommend borrowing this book. It is a lot of fun and it teaches you really cool facts about sharks. I hope you all have the most wonderful day and I can't wait to reach you all next week. Bye-bye.